praise the Lord.
나루 또나 있는 애고이클라카.
This evening,
이런 거 아름하고.
I want to know how many are dead and how many are living.
야드고 힌나 가두디 야드고 뚜르나 가두디 모 카칼라 메두.
If you are dead, you can be quiet.
눈은 히두 보노 눈 아초바 주룹바 둘라카.
If you are alive.
저도 눈 뚜르도 나 보노.
I want to shout praise the Lord.
모문남 있는 애고이클라카 암라 곡도 메두.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you alive?
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Some are dead. We need to have funeral service tonight.
Funeral service kumling nang
It's already going to be 7:30.
Oi ja 7:30 taduku.
Time for dinner.
Oi ja achil dobduku.
If you are hungry,
nun jodi kanodu bolo,
you can take out your hand.
Nun alakan helen toka.
The food that you ate in the river.
Nun achin boke hibu bohilo achin dorma mepatoka.
You can smell it.
Will
fill your stomach. That's why I did not wash my hand with soap. I can still smell.
It
is such a wonderful time together this afternoon. I really enjoyed eating all the fish from the river. But I also want to apologize on behalf of Reverend Dini myself. Because we don't see big fishes. Because 20 years back we came to this place and we had a fishing and we took all the big fishes from this river and we ate likabali.
Munu nyuri ani agoto go mun hogo a dolu a to ke tuna net net na moyem lamen to ke bo hibu bo kem lale ko mun likabli bo bet kula do kube.
From that time onward we have been inquiring whether there's a fish in the river. They said now no more fishes.
Oke mun yuka do ko moyem ba rebe do kure em latin. So if you are
not getting big fishes today, we apologize for that.
Praise the Lord. I really
thank God for this wonderful privilege.
Once again, this
is the last evening for us. I want to thank the program committee once again for giving us this wonderful privilege for us to stand.
Okay, share
the word of God.
Okay,
I'm so much blessed. In fact, both of us are blessed. Because we as a Doke Makbo and Kai Makbo is standing together to share the word of God.
Doke Makbo be ba Kai Makbo be ba Karko Makbo be uno dagdula yun na gagman japad of jinam laga.
I believe this is the inspiration of God to the program committee and giving us this privilege.
Okay, mo program committee ka dumun mahag na relieve mo na abang unam jitu ham agman japdo be.
I will cherish this blessing.
And
our prayer will be all the time for Tabi, Ripo, Baptist
Church. May
the church continue to grow for God's glory. Thank you for the love and hospitality. We will not be able to give you back anything, but I pray that God will bless
you. Continue
to pray for our ministry.
Pray
for Himalayan Bible Institute.
Himalayan Bible Institute
we still have work to do.
And
I brought some calendar to pray for us. So that all the pastors and church can take it to your village and hang in the church, hang in the pastor's house and pray for us.
Okay, mo takam palo gadi ba secretary gadi monduli li abuin gadi an gadi nun bagar kula nun gurjalo ba namlo wa agla agre la munu la kumbur jila kam la kumdak
we will not ask for donation
ogle amun murko ya konam la kama
but will be given to you free
nunam jinyo ba jidak na
believing that you'll pray for us
meke itu am la agre nu munu la kumbur am la
before I told you the word of God
yin na gamun jamma da ba
I want to start with a job
Moita menir go mengerla menrabla mado.
It can be job for someone. It cannot be a job. Even it cannot be a job for someone.
Atu gona lagala menir be tarpeo ka atu gona lagalo embetamala komrirpe.
But I just want to know whether you understand what we are communicating to you.
Rigere mo chende duje unu be yona gongo jabdu dunun tadar dudi ba tachen dudi tachen madu emla.
One time in one big college.
Lekin gondo mai be kaina college gollo.
There was one teacher.
Oh, ekta master go kato.
He's an atheist.
Bu amram yun isoram ba isoram biswas man go.
Yeah, this man don't believe in God.
Bu isoram biswas man go.
And he's a man who he don't believe in God, and he's the man who said there's no God.
Bu isoram biswas ma au ke bu mento mana isor kaman la.
So in one time in the class,
bu ekta class go lo.
He was standing and challenging the student.
I'm
telling you there is no God.
And I
want to challenge your God.
There
is God.
Isor kama.
Let him come down and hit me.
I'm
telling you there is no God.
If
there is God, let him come and hit
me. Demlaka.
So he had been repeating again and again.
And
he was challenging to them.
I will count
1 to 10.
If
there is God.
Oh, you so kadu
bolo. Come and bang me, hit me.
Oh, demlaka ba motelaka.
So he was counting 1, 2, 3. Four.
Api.
Five.
Ango.
Six.
Akke.
I'm telling you there is no God.
Oh, Isur kama.
If there is God, let him come and hit me.
Isur kadu bolo mo mita nima blaka ba demlaka.
So one boy was standing outside.
Ome go aguma lo dakto.
He came running in.
Bi ome jubato.
He was counting 7.
Oh, yadu lo bi akkanu lo makibedu.
Eight.
And that
student boy.
Omia is student Omia.
He was a very healthy guy.
We have my doctor of Aluva Takotkan.
So when he was about to say 10,
Yadu Lobu 10 and Tabedu,
he came and said, hit him.
We are making a Nimma Pamoka.
He was shocked.
We long car.
Why do you hit me?
And you are not a God.
You are not a God.
No, he's not a God.
And the boy said,
Omia Mendito,
God is busy.
Oh, he's so busy to me.
Before he hit you.
Moment of in the Nitekanka.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God is busy.
You'll never be busy to.
If you play with God,
someone
will take advantage to come and hit
you. No.
So don't play and challenge God.
I warn
you.
Praise the
Lord.
You know, quick do.
Seems like many are getting.
I can see
many white
teeth. Praise
the
Lord. I'm
so excited.
My stand
before you once again.
Nunga penkol la kengo dham dakpa
na deliver this second message.
Oh, he gave na moka leina na dohi brida.
The text has been read for us.
Scripture am nunu la rijika
from Isaiah chapter 54 verse 2.
Isaiah chapter 54 verse 2.
The topic is enlarge your tent.
Okay, nunga hirunga gomla amra nunga porupa nunga namruku regodu gwan kaimola karam namgo.
This is a very familiar passage for many Baptist people.
Higi gomla higi amra munu tute ana Baptist niga de lagalo tabe kabe nam gomla go.
Because this is the message that was very much challenged to many Baptists.
Higi doye higi gomla higi dena munka Baptist niga de mabe menu number rule number gomla go ridu.
Because this message was preached by William Carey.
Yo lagalo higi doye higi gomla higi mualam Carey bu radak ogo him kunato.
There is one pastor conference.
Ekbar ko pastor conference dollo.
Many Baptist churches were influenced by Calvin theology.
Ogo bega Calvin theology ka diga re menil koloke mane higi menil namgo kato ogo.
Calvinism don't believe in preaching the gospel.
Calvin bega lo menre mane ka hame doyu kin mane biswas mato.
They said if God is going to save someone.
Jodi ishwar jodi yembai basai deram.
You don't need to send someone. God will save someone.
Oh, be yembai potai mara kintu bui aye ahire.
So during this one pastor conference.
There na pastor conference gollo.
This is a text that William Carey was preaching.
Higim bomla higim William Carey bui doyu kito.
In Freeland Baptist Chapel.
Freeland Baptist alo chapel alo.
In a place called Nottingham, England.
Oh, England mo ko alo.
On May
30, 1792.
Based on this scripture.
Hogim Bible in puri galla.
This man's message was expect great things from God and attempt great things for God.
Hoga abu mamra yirna lokanun kayam thora toka ka bigla kai nagaran gartaka.
This message challenged many pastors.
Hige bom lagi adna pastor ka din menul to.
From that time onward they started sending out missionaries around the world.
Oh, hamoy ok rille kula mama bul tani mo ko ko bul adna yirna gagar gana missionary potai to ku.
I'm not going to say the same message.
Mohim same do ye mohamba mentama.
But I am going to speak to you.
Rigare monunna ma mela madu.
Based on this scripture.
Hoga gomla hoga dodula.
God's vision.
Yirnaga lobu tuchona ma vision.
At God's vision.
Ishwar bega agar gar ham kachona.
In other words, enlarge God's vision.
Yirna bega a vision mana bega lobu tuchona. Agam kaido ba nun mogge lakala.
Enlarge God's vision.
Yinna bega kacho nam bega him vision igin kairu ba mogge lakala.
This Isaiah.
Higi Isaiah higi amram.
It's known as a mini Bible.
Higi amram anina Bible amlachi di mendu.
Chapter 1 to chapter 39.
Chapter akin loka rilela 39 loba.
Talks about the disobedience and judgment of God upon God's people.
Yirnaga niigadiga yirnaga agman tamaba okke buluk taalo yirnaga bulam jazmen egam agman ho jabdu.
And from chapter 40 onward to chapter 66.
Okay, chapter 40 lokke rilela 66 lobe
talks about what God is going to do new things for his people.
Yirnaga buluk bu niigadiga ali agar go gersam ho jabdu.
As we see in Isaiah chapter 43.
Mun Isaiah 43 lo kan
verse 18 and 19.
Verse 18 19 lo kadu.
Forget the former things.
Or rerona maba ma bayokka.
Don't dwell on the past.
Nunu ga rerona ma nun duyo lo.
See, I am doing a new thing.
Hina go nunu lo ali agaran garrapta
da. How it springs up.
Oh nunu em agaran galla ka.
Do you not perceive it?
Nunu khacho to la ka kanu to la ka.
Do you not know it?
Nun yon chin chen ma.
New thing that I'm going to do for you.
Nunu ga yon ali agar garrapta da kadu du.
So this Isaiah chapter 54.
The Isaiah 54 ago
comes after Isaiah chapter 53.
He came Isaiah 53 lo kaadu.
In Isaiah chapter 53.
Isaiah 53 lo.
It talks about Jesus Christ.
But Jesus Christ be ko mendu.
Who will come and suffer.
Yed tanimo ko adla be dug nilenem endena.
And who will die.
Okay, yed ngunuk lagal hijidena.
And by his blood.
Okay, bege e loka.
We will be healed.
Munuga tubu takam chinam ramam
ma sura. By his blood.
Buyamram.
All our sins will be removed.
Takam murga papam lapang na.
All our curse will be removed.
Oka murga takam murula chenam ben ma kotam raku.
That's why in chapter 54 starts with.
Eglaga chapter 54 ha menrem du.
As we sing, oh barren woman.
Oh tu takam nepo na aninga ma gadda.
Barren woman is a sign of a curse.
Hege nepo na unga dharma na migi emrem mai ba chenam be nam ga ababa ridu.
For the Jewish people.
Jewudi ni ga dik lagalo.
Even in our marriage.
Okay, even mun ga homo lo lachin.
If a woman is married and if not bearing a child is considered as a curse.
Yo lagal emrem ni dire ni mu ara ri gram na ma aup jodi ojo na dharma na mege ekta chenam ga ribe bul ma to.
So it's a very sad thing.
Ege embirito.
A cursed woman cannot enjoy.
Ege ma chenam benam anya ma man man meki moin yanan kama dukosto bereto.
Cannot sing.
But the good news is, now because of Isaiah chapter 53, now because of Jesus Christ, the curse is removed. Now blessing has come. Our blessing has come. There will be no more a barren woman. They will bear a child. And their children will be so much. That's the blessing God talks about. That is God's vision for us. That's why in Galatians, chapter 3.
Galatians chapter 3 law.
There we read.
Munu porire.
Verse 13 onward.
Barka 13 law.
Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. For it is written, curse is everyone who is being hung on a tree. He redeemed us in order that the blessing given to Abraham might come to the Gentiles. So that by faith we may receive the promise of the Spirit. This is what God's vision for us. We are not in the time of Isaiah. We are not 800 years before the coming of Jesus Christ. We are now after the coming of Jesus Christ. Jesus came to this world 2,000 years ago. That's why we have just celebrated
Christmas.
The coming of Jesus Christ. Jesus came to this world. Live among us. Perform so many signs and wonders and miracles for us. To prove that He is God. And He was crucified on the cross. Not because of the sin that He has committed. But He was crucified because of the sin that you and I have committed. He died so that your sin will remove away. He died so that our curse will be taken away. Therefore, if you are in Christ Jesus, Paul says again and again in the book of Ephesians, you are in Christ Jesus. You are no more under the curse. You are taken out from the place of curse to the place of blessing. Before you know Jesus Christ, you are in the position of a curse. Because you are in a curse, there's no peace, no joy in your life. Because of curse, we face so many kind of problems and trouble and sickness in this world. Jesus sees your sorrows, your pain, your suffering. That's why He came to this world. To take away your problem and troubles and sickness. That's why Paul says you are redeemed from the curse. When we believe Jesus Christ, our position changed. You are now not in a place of curse. You are redeemed from this curse to the place of blessing. Here you are cursed. Jesus came to take you to the new place, new position of blessing.
Jesus Christ, Adu Nunu Takam Atimana, Chenam Ben Lapa Gelkula,
this is God's vision for you.
He gave him Yunaga Nunu, Bija Nunuga Lemola, Amen.
That's why
When Jesus asked the disciples, who do you think that I am? And everyone responds something. And Peter responds, Thou art a Messiah, the Son of God. And there Jesus said, Blessed are you, Son of Simon. When we confess Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, that is where you are blessed by God. Many of us were trying to get the blessing of God. How can I get God's blessing? So we pray. We do so many things. We go to prayer center. Searching for God's blessing.